All right, so let's take a step back from analyzing preferences and look at some fundamental mathematics. Let's dig a little bit deeper into the greater than or equal to symbol. First, this symbol is what is called a binary relation on the real numbers. Without getting too technical, think of a binary relation on the real numbers simply as a special function that accepts two real numbers, let's call them the left-hand side number and the right-hand side number, and returns either true or false. Greater than or equal to is such a binary relation, returning, for example, true if the left-hand side number is 9 and the right-hand side number is 4. Greater than, as well as less than and less than or equal to, are also binary relations on the real numbers. They just have different truth tables. Now, some binary relations are a total order and some are not. We will see that greater than or equal to is a total order, while greater than is not. A binary relation, which is a total order, will satisfy four conditions. The first one is totality. Greater than or equal to satisfies this condition for the following reason. For any two real numbers, x and y, it will always be the case that x is greater than or equal to y, or y is greater than or equal to x, or both. It is simply impossible to come up with two real numbers such that both of these are false. The binary relation greater than fails this condition, which we can see if we pick x and y to be the same number. The next condition is called reflexivity. Greater than or equal to is reflexive since x is always greater than or equal to itself. Greater than, however, is not reflexive as x is not greater than itself. The third condition is called antisymmetry. Greater than or equal to is antisymmetric since if x is greater than or equal to y, and y is greater than or equal to x, then it must follow that x and y are the same numbers. Antisymmetry becomes a little bit pointless for the binary relation greater than, since it's impossible for x to be greater than y at the same time that y is greater than x. The fourth and final condition is transitivity. If you have a number x which is greater than or equal to another number y, and this number y is greater than or equal to a third number z, then it must also be the case that x is greater than or equal to z. Transitivity is also satisfied by the greater than relation. Greater than or equal to is not the only binary relation which is a total order that you know of. The less than or equal to is also a total order, which you can convince yourself of by checking each of the four conditions. Let's take what we know about the total order of a binary relation back to our preferences. R2 is the collection of all ordered pairs of two real numbers, and we can think of R2 simply as the collection of all points in the Cartesian coordinate system. Since each point in the Cartesian coordinate system is associated with a particular bundle, R2 is, in our model, the collection of all possible bundles of two goods, even though we exclude from consideration points that are not in the first quadrant. Just like greater than or equal to compares two real numbers, the weak preference relation will compare two bundles, each an element of R2. Therefore, the weak preference relation is a binary relation on R2. Or to be precise, it's a binary relation on the subset of R2, where both coordinates are greater than or equal to 0. So when is the weak preference relation a total order? Well, the same four conditions that we discussed when we talked about the greater than or equal to relation on R must hold. It must be total. In words, that means that either the first bundle is weakly preferred to the second, or the second bundle is weakly preferred to the first, or both. What cannot happen is that we have two bundles and neither is weakly preferred to the other. Such preferences will be excluded from consideration. The weak preference relation is reflexive if any bundle is always weakly preferred to itself. Again, it would be problematic if this was not true, and the consumer claimed that she strictly preferred the second bundle to the first, even though both bundles were identical. Our third condition is anti-symmetry. In terms of the weak preference relation, it states that if the first bundle is weakly preferred to the second, and the second bundle is weakly preferred to the first, then the consumer must be indifferent between the two bundles. Quite reasonable if you think about it. Finally, we have transitivity, which may be a little bit harder to swallow. The weak preference relation is transitive if the following condition always holds. If an individual weakly prefers bundle 1 to bundle 2, and she weakly prefers bundle 2 to bundle 3, then she must also weakly prefer bundle 1 to bundle 3. Simplified to one good, if a consumer prefers an apple to a banana to an orange, and then claims that she would rather have the orange than the apple, then her preferences are not transitive. From now on, it will always be assumed that the weak preference relation is a total order satisfying these four conditions. We will say that preferences are totally ordered if this is the case.